got to secure our borders, and it's a national, it's a federal responsibility. And I would serve on committees that I have serious real-world experience in. I have the T-shirt, Armed Services Committee, Foreign Affairs Committee, the Commerce Committee, maybe Homeland Security. What this country needs to combat these global threats is simple. Now, I'm tainted, I admit it, I make no apologies. I learned at the War College, and they get it right. We need a comprehensive and integrated national security that attacks all these fronts and pulls it to bear at one time. It will return America pride, prestige, and respect around the world where our allies stand with us and our enemies fear us. Brings to bear all elements of national power. It needs to have six core pieces. First, an immigration policy. Allows the states to protect themselves. If you get found here and you're not supposed to be here, we're going to turn you, send you home at your country's expense. And I would never have amnesty. What was that? Will you explain that to me? All that you had to do was be here illegally for 5 years, never get arrested, be under 35, and we'll just give you citizenship. We're not going to worry why you're here. Folks, this is not a garage sale on being a citizen of the United States.
Come on.
We need an energy policy. We all know we need to decrease our dependency on foreign oil. It's draining our economy. But besides that, many of those dollars come back and are used against us in military application and terrorism. We need to decrease the ban on offshore drilling. Now, I wrote a book 2 years ago, right about the time of the oil spill, and I said, I want to see safeguards so that we don't have another spill like we had that one. Now they've got it. My son works at the patent office. He went about patent, he's got to cross his desk. And there's at least two providers now that have technology capabilities to put on these offshore drilling wells that if there's a problem, they can shut it off, and we need to go for it. We need to increase nuclear energy. We need to increase our domestic oil production and our refinery capacity. Just pulling it out of the ground is not going to get it done. We need the Department of Energy and the EPA working to facilitate these processes instead of constantly blocking them.
Amen.
We need an economic policy. We need to spend less, and we need to make more money with less taxes. We got to address both sides of the balance sheet. We got to get back to selling our products and services better than the rest of the world so that we have better jobs and we have better economic growth. We need to cut the spending, but we need a balanced budget amendment so that the government doesn't have this crisis with debt ceiling all the time and start paying off this $14 trillion debt. And we need to restore entrepreneurship and free markets. We need treaties and trade agreements that protect our economic wealth and our well-being. We need to have people in the U.S. Senate, when they do the treaties and trade agreements, that have serious credentials where they really understand the global forces and the economic factors and the global dimensions that drive this global economy and competitive environment that all of our companies have to go out and compete in. We need a foreign policy that returns American pride, prestige, and respect around the world. Our U.S. ambassadors and our embassy teams need to be formidable. That is our front line of defense in these foreign nations, not just political favors because you raised a lot of money for somebody's political campaign. We need to not have treaties or trade agreements with countries that are breaching our patents, harboring terrorists, or don't stand side by side with us at all times. And if you don't stand side by side with us, you are not going to get any foreign aid.
Come on.
We got to stop this. Proliferation of weapons of mass destruction to renegade countries such as Korea and Iran. We need domestic policy here at home. We've got to restore the Constitution as the law of the land. It is the law of the land. We've got to defend the targeting rights of union and government jobs. And we need infrastructure development here that if it's being built here or created or manufactured here, it's American workers, American equipment, American tools. And American materials. And we need an effective Homeland Security Department that truly secures our borders. We need to make sure employers are checking to see that their employees are here legally and in the tax system. And if it's me, I would try terrorists and military tribunals and not the comforts of civilian courts. We simply cannot allow Sharia law courts or banks in our country. And the final sixth one is we need a military policy. We've got to make sure that we maintain the very best military in the world, protect our way of life and our interests and our economic wealth. We've got to make sure we fulfill all of our commitments to our military veterans and their families. Now, I get asked about conducting military operations, so we'll do a quick nutshell on it, but there's only one way to do it. And if we'll let the military leaders do it, they know how to do it right. And you will not have this mismanaged mess that's going on in Libya. Number one, the military is an instrument of force, which means it's an instrument of last resort, that you exhaust every option available to you to try to get whatever this adversary or enemy or threat is to be eliminated. But when the day comes that someone will not play well in the sandbox and they're a threat to us or our good allies, you have to go over to the toolbox and you have to get out the big hammer.
Amen.
When you do it right. Number one, you have clearly defined military objectives so that the leaders and the troops know what their job is. You accurately assess the threat. Who are they? What are they? What do they got? Where are they? How do they use it? And what are their strengths and what's their weaknesses? And then you put together what we call a force package that possesses overwhelming force because we do not want any close football games. And you bring together a fully joint operation that dominates the entire battle space at all levels, strategically, operationally, and tactically, and all environments, land, sea, and air. You have rules of engagement that levels the playing field for our commanders and our troops. You have a very clear vision of the desired end state of what the victory will look like when it's over. Then you turn it loose, you pull them into a pre-designed kill zone, you bring to bear everything you got there, and you kick their rear end. And when the military objectives are achieved, the war is over. And you have an exit strategy that removes the fighting force, and you keep it under military command at all times. And you follow up with a well-orchestrated designed exit strategy that preserves that victory. And you take care of the troops while they're there and after they get home. All right, let's bring this home. Where do we go from here? Folks, we got to continue this fight to take our country back and end these liberal giveaways. Now, all of us that have ever wore a uniform and a badge or a gun and took an oath, protect and defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies, foreign and domestic. We've got to make sure our judges and our Congress and our President protect the Constitution, and we've got to replace the ones that's not doing what's right for America.
Yep, that's right.
Now, we've got to take control of the U.S. Senate in 2012 with real conservatives, as we know. But I'd like to put one more factor on there. Real conservatives that have serious, real-world training, education, and experience to face these global threats. You know, this is a come-as-you-are global war, and we do not have the luxury of on-the-job training. We're trying that in the White House, and how's that working for us? Sometimes I get asked, where do I stand on the Second to Tenth Amendment? And I have a little saying. I think we need a sign at every airport, every harbor, and every road in Florida. You are entering a Tenth Amendment-owned and operated state, and justice will be served with the Second Amendment. Sure, we throw any cap and trade legislation in the trash, any Agenda 21 or UN garbage in the trash, and the Obama health care and high speed rail in the trash for good.
Thank you.
Now, I don't like to talk about other politicians, but I allow myself one exact luxury. Maybe next year we should throw Harry Reid, Nancy Pelosi, and Barack Obama. Legal handcuffs off and let the American spirit and entrepreneurship and competitive advantages get back to work. Restore the family as the pillar of our society and keep the ownership of America in the hands of Americans and out of the hands of the federal government, out of the hands of China, and out of the hands of the United Nations. We got to keep the federal government out of the business of our citizens and our states. We need to lift the ban on onshore drilling. And I will stop using government to collect union dues and paychecks.
Thank you.
Amen. I'd fire Janet Napolitano and get someone running Homeland Security that understands that that job is about protecting the interests of our citizens and not those that are here illegally. We need a full audit of the Federal Reserve. I want to know where our money's going. We may need transparency and accountability in the GAO. And perhaps get rid of the IRS and replace that with a fair tax system. We've got to stop the dumbing down of America and get back to the values and the principles that made our country great. And we need to get the pride of American history the teaching of the Constitution, that flag and the Pledge of Allegiance back in our schools. We've got to stop this political correctness and coddling of radical Islamic extremists. My friends, they want to kill us. We cannot allow them to infiltrate our country. Look at Dearborn, Michigan. We've got to keep it out of the classrooms and out of the textbooks. We must support Israel as the only democracy and ally we have. And I would never issue a building permit for a mosque on sacred American soil stained with the blood of innocent civilians from a terrorist attack. And finally, we've got to secure our borders and no more lip service. Now, if I have a disappointment in my state legislature, it's this conservative legislature that I know we have because I read it in the paper.